Let's analyze the instrumentation amplifier. It's a type of high precision differential amplifier where ideally the common mode gain is zero. In fact, the common mode gain practically is very close to zero with this particular amplifier. Along with that, we eliminate several of the drawbacks with a simpler differential amplifier that I analyzed in the last video. First, let's review that simpler differential amplifier. It had three drawbacks. First of all, it had an input impedance that was lower than it could be. We're not looking directly into the pins of an op amp. We're rather looking through resistors, some of which are connected to ground. Therefore, the input impedance is not as high as it otherwise could be. That's drawback number one, and we're going to eliminate that particular drawback in this video. The second drawback with the differential amplifier from the last video is that the gain cannot be adjusted easily. The reason is that the differential gain is R2 over R1, but R2 over R1 needs to equal R4 over R3 for the common mode gain to be zero. Therefore, if I wanted to adjust the differential gain of this amplifier, I would need to, for example, adjust R2 and R4 simultaneously. That's why the gain can't be easily adjusted. It would be a lot easier, for example, if I could just adjust one resistor rather than two. That's one of the drawbacks that I'm going to eliminate here in just a moment with the instrumentation amplifier. The third drawback is that the actual common mode gain is some complicated function of all of the resistors in the circuit. And although we've designed the circuit so that the common mode gain should be zero, that depends upon all of these resistor values being very well matched to one another. Practically, that might not always be the case, and then our circuit might not have a zero common mode gain as a result. Now, before I get to the instrumentation amplifier's final design, I want to see if we can eliminate one of these drawbacks from the get-go, the low input impedance. Here's what we're going to do. The right side of the circuit here is exactly our differential amplifier, and we've already set these resistors equal to one another so that the common mode gain is going to be zero. It's already a decent instrumentation amplifier, and you can see that what we've done here to the input side is to simply add a buffer. The buffer has a gain of one, and it's sometimes called a voltage follower because the voltage at the output side follows or is equal to the voltage at the input side. The input pin here leads directly to the non-inverting pin of an op amp, so the input impedance here should be really high as possible for this particular op amp. Therefore, it improves upon the input impedance of our differential amplifier, which did not lead directly into the pin of an op amp. By adding a buffer to each of our two input pins, we've now increased the input impedance of the amplifier as a whole. But you see, this isn't the optimal solution for improving the amplifier overall. If one of these buffers does not have precisely a gain of one or precisely a unity gain, then the common mode signal to one pin is going to be amplified a little bit more than the common mode signal going to the other pin. Therefore, the common mode gain of the amplifier as a whole might not be zero. We can improve upon this particular problem through the instrumentation amplifier. Here's what it looks like. It consists of two stages. The first stage is not quite the same as having two buffers, but you can see some similarity. The second stage is just the differential amplifier that we've analyzed before. What's nice about this amplifier is that the differential gain here, 1 plus 2 R2 over R1, can be adjusted by simply adjusting resistor R1. Because the gain can be adjusted by only tuning one resistor, it's an advantage over the differential amplifier that we just looked at. Let's now derive the equations that I'm showing here on the slide. We'll be analyzing stage 2 first. Let's get rid of stage one, and you might notice immediately that the differential amplifier that I'm showing is identical to the differential amplifier that we've previously analyzed. Because all four of the resistors are equal to one another, it causes the differential gain to be one, and the common mode gain is zero. If we call this V1 and this V2, the fact that the differential gain is 1 simply means that the output voltage is 1 times the difference of these two signals from one another. That completes our analysis for the second stage. Now let's look at the first stage. Let's do a common mode analysis first. In other words, I want to show you that the common mode gain is going to be 1 here. We'll thus assume that we have the same signal, VCM, present at the two input pins. If the op amp is giving us a stable output, then these two voltages should be the same, VA should equal VCM. Likewise down here for the lower op amp, VB should also equal VCM. This means that VA equals VB. Since these two voltages are equal to one another, it means that there's no current through resistor R1 in either direction. Since no current flows through R1, no current's going to be flowing through R2 either on the top or the bottom either. Since we don't have any current through any of these three resistors, it means that the voltage drop across these resistors has to be zero. Remember, V equals IR. If current is zero, then the voltage drop also has to be zero. This means that V1 needs to be equal to V2, which needs to be equal to VA, which needs to be equal to VB. Everything is equal to the common mode voltage. Therefore, the common mode gain is just one. What's nice about this first stage is that even if our resistors are not very well matched, it's not going to affect our common mode gain. It's still going to be one. That's an advantage. Now let's go for the differential analysis and see how that works out. I'm going to start by drawing our differential signal. You might notice that I've drawn it upside down. The reason why I've done that is because if we look back at our instrumentation amplifier, you might notice that the non-inverting pin here of our differential amplifier portion is on the lower side. Therefore, I'm putting the positive pin of our input signal on the lower side just to match it. Let's define our mathematical ground here. That means that this is 0 volts, and if the op amp is working correctly, it implies that this is going to be 0 volts as well. This voltage is just VD, and this voltage should also be VD. Let's label some of our currents, I1, I2, and I3. These currents need to equal one another. We can use Ohm's law now to find them. For I1, I need to apply Ohm's law to resistor R2. There's V over R. Now for I2, we need to apply Ohm's law to resistor R1. That's VD minus 0 over R1. And then for current I3, we just need to apply Ohm's law to resistor R2. That's 0 minus V1 over R2. Let's now multiply everything times R2. I can take the first equality and use it to write voltage V2 in terms of VD. I can then take the second equality and just write voltage V1 in terms of voltage VD. You might recall that stage 2 of our amplifier had a differential gain of 1. That means that our output voltage was just 1 times the difference between V2 and V1. We can now substitute for V2 and V1. There's V2 and there's V1. Finally, we have our output voltage in terms of our applied differential signal. This tells us our differential gain. It matches what I started off saying it was going to be. Let's now summarize what we've done. We've created an amplifier where the overall common mode gain is zero. That is, one times zero is just zero. If our resistors in stage one, R1, R2, and R2, are not well matched to one another, it's not going to affect the common mode gain. It's still going to be zero. Of course, if our resistors here in stage two are not all identical to one another, that could affect the common mode gain. But the advantage of having the resistors all the same rather than having two resistors the same and two other resistors being the same is that we're more likely to be able to obtain a matched set. The common mode rejection ratio of the instrumentation amplifier overall is therefore limited by the matched resistors in stage two along with the common mode rejection ratio of the op amp itself. It's an improvement over the differential amplifier that we looked at in the last video, for example. The overall differential gain of our instrumentation amplifier is the differential gain of stage 1 times that of stage 2, or 1 plus 2 R2 over R1. The gain is easily adjustable because we have only one resistor R1 in the circuit. We could make it a tunable resistor, and then it would be very easy just to tune that single resistor in order to adjust our gain. What's also nice about the instrumentation amplifier is that it has a very high input impedance. The input impedance is just limited by the input impedance of the two op amps here at the input stage. In summary, we have an instrumentation amplifier with a high input impedance, a very high common mode rejection ratio, and an easily adjustable gain.